Hi guys, welcome back to Corner Next Sprites, and today we look at SQL injection. This is the first of a series of videos that will be looking into SQL injection. I will begin by showing you how to set up a database, or your own database in this case, where you'll be able to perform your SQL injection tests and do just about anything from the same database, because you'll have permission to do that, legal permission. You find that whenever you're doing SQL injection, you'll be operating outside the law unless you have written consent from whoever's system you'll be targeting. Now, under normal circumstances, I insist this is not allowed, this is illegal, it will land you in prison, and I am only doing this for educational purposes. So to begin with, there is a tool called SQL Map. If you don't have it, you can go find it online. It's very easy to locate in the GitHub pages, and even Kali Linux, maybe ParrotOS like I am, BlackHat Linux, these are some of the tools that come pre-installed. So I'll show you where I found my web application. This is the web application I'll be setting up. I'll show you how to set it up and how I can access it going forward. That is how you can perform SQL injection tests, by fetching the databases within it, checking for vulnerabilities, and running exploits on the same web application to find any vulnerabilities that you can exploit. I'll also show you how search engines work by indexing pages, and how you can use that, because that is legal, how you can use that to get information on any website out there that uses PHP ID command, which is also the same technique that web crawlers from the major search engines such as Google rely upon. So first things first, navigate to this website, dvwa.co.uk. You'll find the DEM vulnerable web application, and using this you can find easily here in the instruction manual that it says it's a web application that is DEM vulnerable, and its main goals are to aid security professionals to test their skills and tools in a legal environment. Keyword is legal. Otherwise, going beyond that, you'll be infringing the law, and that will land you in prison. So when you download the file, I already have it downloaded. It's here. So I'll quickly extract it, and here it is. So this is what we'll do. Going back to my terminal, I'll navigate and open my file explorer as root, not here, as root, and it says do not do anything outside of the scope that I'll be showing you, because after that you'll be compromising your own system and you'll leave yourself in big trouble. So first of all, let's go to the file system, navigate to home, corner, downloads. I'll copy this, the folder that I've already extracted, copy that and come back here. I'll go into var, www folder, like that. You can delete this or leave it there, there's no problem with that, and then you'll copy it in here. Another option after copying it that way, coming back here, I can clear that up, I can navigate into the same folder, and listing out my files, you find that my folder is here. Now, to check the reason why I had to open my file explorer as root, is to ensure that I would be able to write into this folder because of the permission levels in the folder, they are root. Otherwise, after setting that up and downloading it, in the next video we'll be exploring how you can exploit that, how you can set up your own web server, and how you can use the search engines to find possible websites that you can perform SQL scans to fetch the databases. But I'll not be showing how to do SQL injections because that is illegal and I do not have permission. Also in the next video we'll be exploring how to perform SQL injection attacks on Metasploitable and how to get elevated access. Like in this case, you can see clearly I'm in the MSF admin account, but if I was to go into the sudo and ask the same who am I, you see I'm root. So I will be showing you how to do the same on any system that you have permission on, how to elevate your privilege or escalation of privileges through SQL attacks. However, I strongly feel that this is not something you really need to know, because in the modern world, very few systems rely on PHP, and PHP is what allowed us to have SQL attacks with great ease. That's how you've seen the number of attacks that have come through brute forcing databases have reduced, and now it mainly relies on social engineering techniques, getting that malicious drive, that malicious software into another system, or even fooling a user using various attacks into giving you information that they would otherwise not have given you, and leveraging this information to access their systems. Now, otherwise, please hit that like and subscribe button, and I'll be seeing you next week. Thank you.